Hello, we are discussing about GATE 1996 ECE paper, and this question is related to digital circuits. Schottky clamping is resorted in TTL gates to reduce propagation delay, to increase noise margin, to increase packing density, to increase fan out. What can be the right option for this one? Okay, the right answer is nothing but A. Right answer is A. Schottky clamping is mainly used in the TTL gates to reduce the propagation delay. Okay, so we will see how can the Schottky clamping is going to be used to reduce propagation delay. Before using the Schottky TTL, TTL is going to be employing ordinary transistors. The ordinary transistor is nothing but which is a 3 terminal device, and this is ordinary transistor with arrow implies emitter, and this is collector, this is base. So ordinary transistor is going to be made to be act as either on or off condition. So by that time, on implies nothing but the transistor must be in saturation region, okay, and off implies nothing but the transistor must be in cutoff condition. Okay, so saturation implies nothing but both. Every transistor has two junctions. One is nothing but emitter base junction, the other is collector base junction. Because this arrow implies nothing but it is NPN transistor, that is nothing but collector of N type, emitter of N type, and base is of P type. So if you observe, there is a PN junction between collector and base, that is called as JC. JC is going to be a PN junction between collector and base, and the other is nothing but JE, PN junction between emitter and base. Base is common for both junctions. So these both junctions, JC as well as JE, JC must be forward bias and JE also must be forward bias. That is what saturation condition. Cutoff implies nothing but JC must be reverse bias and JE must be reverse bias. That implies nothing but here both junctions should be reverse bias. Okay, so both junctions must be move from forward bias to reverse bias for saturation to cutoff condition. That is nothing but on to off state. For on to off transition, at that time both junctions must be made reverse bias from forward bias. Otherwise, both junctions may be made to be forward bias from reverse bias when the switch is going to be going from the off to on condition. If the switch is coming from the off to on condition, by that time both the junctions must be forward bias, okay, from the reverse bias condition. So both junctions are involving, okay, so that it takes longer time. Now if you use Schottky TTL is nothing but where the TTL transistors are going to be replaced with Schottky TTL transistors. Before going for the Schottky TTL transistors, we should discuss about Schottky diode first. This is going to be treated as Schottky diode. It's going to be looks like ordinary diode with P and N, and the symbol is going to be slightly changed. It is going to be looks like S. So this is called as Schottky diode. So this is P side and it is N side. The main advantage of this one is nothing but whose forward voltage, okay, that is nothing but whenever the diode is under forward bias, the voltage drop across this one is nothing but around 0.4 volts, that is 400 millivolts. So if you are going to use this one between the collector and base, okay, if you use this one across the collector and base, at that time that is going to be treated as Schottky transistor. So Schottky transistor is nothing but like this. You are going to use the Schottky diode. You are going to use a Schottky diode between collector and base such that base is going to be of P side and collector is of N side. So by that time, the voltage across this collector and base is going to be around 0.4 volts with plus and minus. And this is base emitter. Whenever it is in the base emitter, that is nothing but emitter base junction is in the forward bias. Whenever it is under forward bias, at that time this is 0.7 volts is going to be the voltage drop across base to emitter, with base is more positive, okay, because it is NPN transistor, base is of N type, base is of P type, so that P must be more positive to make the forward bias. So now calculate VCE. VCE implies nothing but plus minus, apply KVL around this loop. Apply KVL starting from this ground and going through this loop like this and coming back to this point. So apply KVL. Now by using KVL we can write it as VCE plus 0.4 minus 0.7 is equal to 0. So VCE is equal to what you are getting is 0.3 volts. So we know that one, this is going to be greater than VCE saturation. So whenever the transistor is in saturation, at that time VCE is going to be having typical value as less than or equal to 0.2 volts. The maximum value of VCE saturation is 0.2 and always it will be less than 0.2 only. So here the VCE, whenever you are using clamping Schottky diode, at that time the VCE is 0.3 volts. So VCE is 0.3 volts is nothing but now the transistor is in active mode. So it is no more in saturation region whenever the transistor is in on condition, and it will be in active region when the transistor is in on condition. Active region implies nothing but, okay, so in this case on condition is nothing but whenever the transistor is on, at that time this is going to be active region. Active region implies nothing but JE is forward bias and JC is reverse bias. Collector bias junction is reverse bias, emitter bias junction is forward bias. Now if you want to make a transition from forward to reverse or reverse to forward, okay, cutoff condition is nothing but same as this one, cutoff is, and here it is on condition is nothing but active. Active is nothing but only emitter bias junction is forward bias, collector bias junction is reverse bias. Now if you want to move from off to on state and on to off state, at that time only emitter bias junction should be considered. That has to be the reverse bias if it is forward bias, otherwise it has to make forward bias if it is under reverse bias. So by changing only one PN junction, okay, you are achieving the switching between on to off state as well as off to on state, whereas for a normal transistor you are going to do this for the both the junctions, but now you are going to do it for the only one junction. So definitely this takes less amount of time. As well as if you know, whenever the transistor is switching from cutoff to saturation, there will be a large excess minority charge will be created under saturation region. That makes, okay, first of all it has to be removed and later it must come to the reverse bias. So that takes longer time to remove the stored charge whenever it is under forward bias, that too in saturation region. But under on condition, if it is going only to the active region, at that time there will not be much stored charge in the junction. So removal of stored charge is going to be, the time required for the removal of stored charge can be less, so that the transistor is going to be working very fast. So Schottky TTL is going to be called as non-saturated logic family, whereas normal TTL, that is standard TTL, is called as saturated logic family. Saturated logic family means whenever it is in the on condition it will go to saturation region, whereas non-saturated logic family is nothing but whenever the transistor is in on condition it will go to active region, it will don't go for the saturation region. So Schottky TTL is very fast compared to standard TTL. So Schottky clamping is mainly used. Schottky clamping is nothing but using a Schottky diode between collector and base like this, and this is going to be symbolized as Schottky transistor by using this. Instead of a single line, we are going with S over here. So this is Schottky transistor symbol that includes a Schottky diode between collector and base. Okay, that is very fast. So in this way, we can reduce the propagation delay. Thank you.